Hi, I'm Patrick. This specific video is basically to help you to understand what chart types are important for CAT data interpretation section. So I am a 6 times 100% in DILA section, also overall 6 times CAT 100%. So fairly fair idea about what is required for cracking the DILA section. So what will be discussed? So one is what is important to crack the CAT DI section. I mean, what is important or how do you go about it? Example of how to understand charts. That's one thing that people don't. People tend to calculate too much. So let's understand how to understand the different charts. So one example of it. And what are different types of chart types that are important? Okay. Or different types of charts that are important. So what is important? One is, and most important thing is to understand the chart. What happens in the CAT exam is that there are always new type of charts that come in. So it takes time to understand and comprehend the chart. And once you understand the chart, there's a lot of time spent in just calculations. CAT DI normally doesn't expect you to calculate too much. You can normally interpret it by looking at the graph. But unfortunately, because we don't understand the chart given to us, we tend to calculate a lot. So the first step would be to understand the chart. I'll give you an example on this. Second is, we tend to do a lot of calculations, but normally what happens in the CAT DI is the options are far. You can easily approximate and get the answer as quickly as possible. But since we are prone to calculation, we tend to waste a lot of time in accurate calculations. So you need to learn approximation as far as DI is concerned. And third, yes, you need to calculate quickly, normal calculations, simple calculations, so that you can solve things faster because DI does require a lot of calculations. So three parts that are important as far as CAT DI is concerned. Let's try to understand how to understand charts. I'm just given a simple bar chart as such. Now, which place here in a sense like Kent, Lincoln, Merck or York, and in which quarter show the highest percentage increase in revenue? Now, I've just kept the question vague, but the key out here is to try to look at the data and try to get the answer quickly. If I look at the data, I can clearly make out that York from 2001 quarter three to quarter four has almost doubled. Look at from the graph, it's doubled, right? I mean, almost doubled. So automatically you can make out that it will be your Q4. That will be the answer for this because it's doubled during that particular period. So you should be able to look at the chart and make out, okay, yeah, this is the answer. Okay, because the data has doubled, therefore automatically the answer should be your. I mean, I'm not calculating anything, I'm not doing anything. Also, one more reason that it is highest is because the base is low. Normally, when the base is low, the percentage growth is higher. So automatically you can make out. Similarly, I give one more. Which quarter is the highest percentage decrease? Now, if you look at it properly, you can make out a two decrease. One is Q1 to Q2 in Lincoln. Okay, there's a decrease. Okay, and the second, if you look at it, again, York from Q2 to Q3, there is a decrease. Now you can make out very clearly that Lincoln, the decrease is more than York, but I have also taken York into picture because the base is low. When the base is low, base in a sense, from with respect to which you're calculating from this value to this value. When the base is low, the percentage decrease is higher. Percentage is higher. So though it is, I said Lincoln has a higher decrease in terms of absolute value, but I would also consider York because the base is lower. Also, if you look at it, if I want to find a percentage decrease, you can make out that almost one third has decreased. Okay, almost one third of the whole value. I'm doing this without calculation. I'm just looking and drawing, seeing the chart and looking at it. So the approximate decrease will be 33%. Same out here. The approximate decrease is one third, something on 33%. Approximate. It is just a ballpark value. I'm not saying the exact value. Same way when I said the increase in the first case is almost double. So approximate increase would be 100% increase. Again, the approximate value, I'm not taking the accurate value. So this is how you calculate. I mean, you can always shortlist the option, get the answer quickly just by looking at the charts. If you're able to understand the charts without calculations, right? Now, what are different charts that are important for DI? So almost all types, you can table, bar, line, pie, scatter, web. These three are what have come in the exam in the past, scatter, web. Though it is not very common in other exam, but But if you look at in the CAT, these type of charts have come in the exam, the scatter plot, the web radar, the bubble, etc. Also the mix type, any mixture of these also do is very common. You can look at that. So try to get used to charts which are not very common. What we do is we normally focus on only bar, line and pie. We don't get used to the other type of charts. They're not difficult. I mean, if it comes in the exam, you can definitely comprehend it. But it makes sense to get used to those so that if it comes in the exam, you should be able to solve quickly, right? That's the basic idea. So try solving different types of charts that do come, and that will help you to get comfortable with the charts of different types. Right. Thank you.